This video shows how to run percentile analysis with the Unity 3 measuring system. This measurement requires preconditions, such as an audiogram with minimum threshold values of 500, 1000, 2000, and 4000 Hz to be able to calculate a prescription target. To access the percentile analysis, navigate to the speech mapping main page by clicking on the speech mapping icon on the left side of the screen. On that main page, you find a list of previous measurements in the area Measurement History. Entries listed here can be double-clicked to open in read-only mode or together with a new measurement if the box Show with Current is checked. To open the measurement window, simply click on the SM Measurement button. In case you want to start with a clean and empty grid, click the New Measurement button prior to opening the measurement window. Before you start the analysis, make sure the probe tube is properly inserted into the client's ear. Carefully insert the hearing aid into your client's ear canal, while the probe tube is kept still in its place. For more detailed information, please have a look at our REM tutorial. Prior to the measurement, have the hearing aid programmed with first fit settings and make sure that the omnidirectional microphone setting is activated. In the Unity Speech Mapping window, select the entry Percentile 65 dB from the test type list on the right. This loads the default settings necessary for the measurement, for example, the signal and the level to be used. The default test signal for percentile measurements is the ISTS signal. The signal can be selected from a drop-down box located right below the level control. To start the measurement, simply click on the play button. Initially, a room equalization sound is played. After the equalization has been completed, the measurement will start automatically. After the measurement is completed, the results of the percentile analysis are displayed on your screen and can be compared to the fitting target. The LTAS line should match the black target line, and the area covered with the percentile bars should roughly match the gray speechogram area. In our example, this is not yet the case. Use the manufacturer's fitting application to adjust the hearing instrument output level, represented by the dashed LTAS curve, to match the target. To see the changes applied in the hearing aid settings more instantly in the measured curve, activate the loop function located below the play button. This allows the measurement to run continuously, taking an average every 5 seconds to react quickly to changes. Click on the On Top Mode icon to minimize the measurement screen and overlay it on the fitting application window. Once the LTAS curve is matched, check that the bottom line of the blue bar at 1000 Hz is above the hearing threshold level. As the blue bar represents the soft portion of speech, it will indicate that soft sounds are still audible with speech input on average loudness level. If this is not the case, consider increasing the gain for soft sounds. Now the hearing aid has been fitted for a medium sound level input and should already match loud sounds targets due to its pre-configured compression setting from the first fit. To verify this, run a percentile measurement with an 80 dB input level and select the entry Percentile 80 dB from the test list to load the test settings necessary. An averaging time window of 1 minute should automatically be set to ensure compliance to measurement standards. As we can see, the LTAS curve matches the 80 dB target curve fairly well already. However, it is important to check that the upper ends of the pink bars are not exceeding the uncomfortable loudness curve. If this is the case, adjust the gain for loud sounds accordingly. Optional step. If necessary, a verification measurement with soft input level 50 or 55 dB can be performed. For low input level, it is not necessary that the soft portions all become audible. Hence, it would be acceptable once the target is met with the LTAS that the bottom ends of the blue bars may extend below the hearing threshold level. After the measurements are done, click the Save button and all the actions will be saved. To return to the speech mapping main page, press the Close button or click on the little X in the top right corner.